Covington Catholic returned on this wet Wednesday, but it was far from a return to normalcy. Officers were positioned in the lot, at the front doors, inside the high school, heightened security that is open-ended for now. Students were back amid anonymous threats of putting them through wood chippers, shooting up their school, locking them inside, and burning the building down. A police cruiser moved past American flags, patrolling due to death threats towards children.
The vast majority of the threats I've seen have come from long distances away. However, I am aware of some that are from the state of Kentucky. So, you know, whether or not they're local, I just don't know yet. I just know that there are some that have come from within the state.
The earliest ones surfaced Saturday after the initial video clip increased in intensity through Monday. Most now are retweets and duplicates. CovCath says unless otherwise scheduled, only students, faculty, and staff can come and go. Trying to identify, find, and prosecute those who made these restrictions necessary will likely take a lot of time.
A lot of this is done with grand jury subpoenas that take weeks or months for the companies to comply with, to get the information, the records, the proof we need to go forward with charges. So this isn't something that's going to be over in the next couple days.
Commonwealth Attorney Rob Sanders acknowledges the degree of difficulty here, not only proving who an account belongs to, but proving whose hands were on the keyboard at the time threats were made. Calling the power of social media staggering and scary, Sanders spoke of how a sense of security can be destroyed in a matter of minutes.
Even people that had nothing to do with this incident that are now getting death threats because somebody misidentified the face that they saw in the video.
And as you look live once again at the scene we have here at the Covington Diocese, we can tell you that investigators face a big job on this. They're going to sort through 20,000 emails that employees have received to find the ones that constitute a threat. And this scene that you're looking out live is a suspicious package investigation at the Covington Diocese. The diocese has been evacuated. Traffic still moving along Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard here, but Madison Road is blocked. This is just past the Basilica, the Cincinnati Bomb Squad on the scene, and emergency management as well. We'll update you as warranted. Live in Covington, John London, WLWT News 5.
All right.